Hi, I'm James Hicks, an American organist who is now in the beautiful sacred space of the Uranienborg Kirke, located in the heart of the capital city of Oslo, Norway. I've been here all week here, the last week of March 2022, making the double disc project Nordic Journey Volume 12, a project devoted entirely to the music of Norway, and it's been a splendid, unique occasion in two really essential ways. First, we're celebrating a birthday, and it's the 75th birthday tomorrow, actually, March 31st, of the eminent Norwegian artist Kjell Mørk Karlsen, whose music really figures prominently on this particular recording. We also, secondly, invited a number of musicians from all around the capital area to help celebrate this occasion. And so we welcomed Caroline Eidsten Dahl, a wonderful recorder virtuoso playing music of Karlsen's father, Rolf Karlsen, a 20th century church musician here in Oslo. And then we welcomed the three-member percussion ensemble, SISU, which performed the triptychon of Kjell Mørk Karlsen, a really engaging work for 33 different percussion instruments and organ. And so you go through the sonic capabilities, not only the organ, but all these different sounds with exotic percussion instruments. Yesterday, we welcomed four local violinists who played Kjell Mørk Karlsen's suite for folk musicians and organ. And this is a very attractive foray into the beautiful world of Norwegian folk music. And then today we're welcoming four members from the Oslo Philharmonic, brass players in a festive arrangement by Fridtjof Andersen, 20th century composer writing in the Romantic tradition, a fantasy based on the German chorale Vom Himmel hoch.
Triptychon for organ and percussion was composed in 1999 for the premiere of a new Rige organ in Molde Cathedral in Norway. This extensive piece, where organ and 33 percussion instruments are used, has its background from the first verses of the Gospel of St. John, which tell about the Word which always has been on the earth. In the first movement, with a dramatic use of a lot of drums, we can feel the beginning of the earth. In the second movement, with different small and big bells, the light come and shine. And the last movement with different symbols tells about the Word which was given as a gift to the earth. The triptychon is like a concert for organ and percussion players. Sometimes it is very strictly in its form, and sometimes the groups are more independent from each other, and here they play in a style more like an improvisation.
Thank you.
Suite for organ and folk music violins was written in 1992. This opus is very much related to melodies from a strong and solid folk music tradition in Norway. Originally, these melodies was played on violins or flutes in connection with popular social parties. So it has been very interesting for me to move these melodies into the church room and introduce them together with organ. The starting point for these different movements has always been the melodies, and from this, the solistic organ parts has been created.